Okay. The next part in the endocrine, that is the pancreas. So we all in the digestive, there also I mentioned about the pancreas. So where it is, and again there also I told we will discuss in detail. So when you will take in the endocrine system. So what is this pancreas? The pancreas, this is the mixed variety. So it is a mixed type of gland, and it is present in the posterior abdominal wall. So what do you mean by mixed? So it is having both exocrine as well as endocrine functions. In the exocrine part, it produces the digestive enzymes. It produces digestive enzymes which helps for the digestion of digesting part. And in the endocrine function, it secretes insulin and glucagon. So these are the endocrine hormones. So if there is any variation, so if there is decreased production of the insulin, it causes diabetes mellitus. So these are the conditions what will have. And where it is present? So it is present, or it is the site where it is lies in the posterior abdominal wall behind the peritoneum of the lesser sac. So this is near the back. So posterior abdominal wall means it is related near to the back of the body. And then at what vertebral level? So it lies at the vertebral level of lumbar 1 and second vertebra. And from where it is extended? See here, in this structure I made a, so what is this? This is the duodenum. So in the digestive system also we discussed the same thing. The C-shaped curve of the duodenum, where the head of the pancreas is present. So that is the, from this area the pancreas is extended. Till where? Extended to the hilum of the spleen. Okay, you got it? Extends from the concavity or the C-shaped concavity of the duodenum to the hilum of the spleen. This is the area where the pancreas is present. It has the parts. What are the four parts? The head, neck, body and the tail. So here, head, neck, body and tail of the pancreas. So this is the area where the hilum of the spleen is present. I will discuss one by one. So what is the head? So we already discussed where the head is present. It is present in the concavity, that is the C-shaped concavity of the duodenum, this area. And it has the two part. The one is the head proper, and another one is uncinate process. The head is subdivided into another part. That part is called uncinate process of the pancreas. Okay. Next, the neck of the pancreas. So where the neck of the pancreas is present? This neck of the pancreas is present at the transpyloric plane. Okay. Transpyloric plane means, so when you draw a transverse line in the body, there is one line which crosses, which we have to draw transversely. That line is called transpyloric plane. Pyloric, trans means transverse, pylorus means so near to the pancreas, like this. Now where I have drawn the line, so this is the line called transpyloric plane, just we'll consider this as an abdomen. Okay, like this. This is the abdomen. So we have to draw the line like this. This is the transpyloric plane. So where this transpyloric plane crosses, it lies opposite to the first lumbar vertebra. It lies opposite to the first lumbar vertebra. So where this line is? This line at the junction. So at the junction of jugular notch. So if you draw sternum here and symphysis pubis, the lower part where the pelvis bone is present, in between middle of the body. So this is clear here. This transpyloric plane is clear. Next. So what is the anterior relation here? Anteriorly, where it is present? Anteriorly, it is junction between the stomach and the first part of the duodenum, this part, where you see this constriction. This is the area, it is the anterior part. Posteriorly, the junction between the splenic vessels and the mesenteric vein here in this diagram. So what happens? What is the anterior relation of the neck of the body? Anterior relation, there is a junction of stomach and first part of the duodenum. Okay. Whereas the posterior or behind, so what structure? There is a junction at this junction where the splenic and superior mesenteric vein, these two vein joins to form portal vein. Okay. Where this portal vein is present? It is present behind the neck of the pancreas. Next, the body. Again, the body lies in the transpyloric plane. So when you take a section, it is triangular in shape, and anteriorly it is covered by peritoneum and is related to the peritoneum of the lesser sac. This one, this is the anterior relation. So this is the peritoneum of the lesser sac and the stomach. Usually the body of the stomach is related to the body of the pancreas. Next, on the inferior surface, below, just below the body, if this is the, this is the body of the pancreas. So anteriorly we studied, and now what is the structures related to the below? The first one, the duodeno-jejunal flexure. So it means where the duodenum ends and the beginning of the jejunum. So that curve. Next one, the coils of jejunum, the second one. And the next structure which is related, that is left colic flexure. What is the another name of left colic flexure? Another name of left colic flexure is the splenic flexure. Okay. Next, the posterior relation of the body of the pancreas. See here, all the relations are different in different part. The head relations are different, neck relations are different, and the body relations are different, and the tail relations are different. What are the relations? It is related to eight structures. So they are two vessels, two muscles, two glands, and two veins. So what they are? The vessels are abdominal aorta, superior mesenteric artery. and the muscles are diaphragm and the left psoas major muscle. This one, this is the left psoas major muscle, and the left kidney and left suprarenal gland, the splenic vein and the left renal vein. And the tail of the pancreas, it runs. So where it passes? It passes between the two layers of leno-renal ligament. It passes here. It passes between these two structures and gets attaches to the spleen. Along with this, it also carries the splenic vessels. So where it is related? It is related to the hilum of the spleen. Okay. Next. So what are the gonads? The gonads. So there are the gonads in the female, it is called ovary, and the gonads in the male, it is called testis. So these two also, they secrete the hormones. They are called sex hormones. The hormones in the both the sex, they are estrogen and progesterone from the ovary, and the androgen and the testosterone from the testes. So these are the hormones, different hormones secreted in male and female. Next one is the pineal gland. This is the small endocrine gland present in the brain. This one secretes melatonin. So this melatonin, it helps in our, it maintains our sleep and when to sleep and when to get up. This hormone, it maintains our the sleep and wakeness of our activity. So if there is any problem, so there may be, so there is lot of disturbance in this activity. Sometimes you may, there will be a loss of sleep also. Sometimes the patient will sleep continuously like that. Okay. And it also have a small, it also have a role in sexual maturation. So when the sexual maturation, that is a secondary sexual activities or secondary sexual structures of the body, development of secondary sexual structures of the body. So all these are maintained by pineal gland. Okay. So any doubts in this? If you have any questions, you can ask regarding the endocrine system and everything. Okay. And one more thing I want to announce. So by evening you will get an details of the assignments. You have to submit assignments by next week. So the details will be announced in the blackboard, and all the students, you will be divided in the groups. Okay. I have made the groups also, and along with the groups, just below the groups, they will have the topic. Okay. This topic, each and every student has to submit one copy in the blackboard in the PDF format. I've given all the details. Okay. This is not the group. It is the all the persons in each group, they have to submit one copy, and it should not be the same. Okay. If if the copy which is submitted by any student, like same as your friend, totally same, then you will lose the marks. So this assignment carries 4 marks. Okay, so each and everyone has to submit. The topic is the same, but the content has to be different from each other, like the sentences, and you have to write, sometimes you have to write in your own sentences. Okay, 35% of the 35% of the plagiarism is acceptable. Only 35% you can take. You can take the sources of internet, whatever it is. So if totally, if you get something, the same topic in the internet, same copy and paste, means it will be identified in the blackboard. Everything will be identified. Okay, so in that case you will lose the marks. Okay, 4 marks for the assignments. And one more thing regarding yeah, short answers are there, that still we will decide, still we have to decide. So whether to it is not yet decided for right now, that will tell. Regarding practical exams, by in the next week, so I will take the for the practical. Okay, what I will do, so I will give the PowerPoint. So which are the this is for the present information. Okay, the further is there any changes, I don't know. So we have taken the specimen pictures from the lab, and then same pictures will be there in the PowerPoint, and then so they will be labeled like this. Now what you are seeing, this one. Okay, see here. So now you are seeing the parts of pancreas. So example, so there is digestive system, all the other things are there. So there I will label, so identify this structure, and then name the parts. So in this, the picture, the slides, which I am giving, so it contains only the pictures and their names. What are the names we are asking? Okay, the related theory, the related lecture part, you have to study from the PPT of the lectures. No details will be there in the practical slides. So you will have only pictures and the names. Yes, pictures and names. Okay, you got my point? Okay, next week I will take the regarding the specimens. Okay, you got my point? By today evening I will make the announcement of the assignments. After announcing, if you have any doubts, or if you have any doubts, you can ask me regarding assignments now. No doubts. By next week, everything, the dates and all mentioned. Next Saturday, okay? That is on 14th. Okay, if there is no doubt, shall we close the session?